Cartilage is the coating on the end of a bone. If you look at the end of a chicken bone, that shiny white cap that you see on the end of a drumstick, that's cartilage. It coats the ends of all our bones. Anytime there's a bone meeting another bone, which is a joint, there's going to be a coating of cartilage on both sides, which provides a nice, smooth, glossy surface so that when they rub up and down against each other, they glide rather than produce friction. When you have injury to that cartilage, either a traumatic defect like a pothole, or if it's just worn away, if you could imagine sandpaper kind of rubbing it away over a larger area, both of those things are considered arthritis because technically arthritis is damage to the cartilage or injury to the cartilage. So patellofemoral arthritis is arthritis that predominantly affects the joining between the patella and the groove in the femur or the trochlea. And in the knee, there are what we divide the knee into three different compartments, the medial or the inside of the knee, which is the articulation or the joining between the end of the thigh bone and the tibia, and that same articulation on the lateral side or the outer side. And then underneath the kneecap is the third compartment. And that's the compartment that we're really talking about. When we talk about somebody who has isolated patellofemoral arthritis, we're saying that they have lost the cartilage or damaged the cartilage severely underneath the kneecap and in the groove, but where they have fairly well preserved cartilage in the rest of that knee. Just as with all patellofemoral conditions, patellofemoral arthritis does more commonly affect women than men. In patients who've had instability is more common in women than men, so those patients are obviously going to be a larger group. Oftentimes, patients who've had patellofemoral instability or have had multiple dislocations over their life will eventually develop significant arthritis because of the damage to their cartilage that they've done from the instability, and we call that post-instability arthritis. There are other patients, we call it post-traumatic, very similar to post-instability, but somebody who might have fallen or sustained an acute injury to their knee when they were younger damaged the cartilage behind their kneecap or in the groove, and then it progresses on to patellofemoral arthritis as they've gotten older. And then there's another subset of patients who have generalized osteoarthritis, which is the most common arthritis we see, and it may go on to affect the rest of their knee eventually, but at least the initial presentation is presenting as patellofemoral arthritis. We always try to approach these through ways without surgery first and see if they work. The most common ways are physical therapy, really strengthening the leg to help to unload the joint will always be something that helps. Losing weight can help with all patients who have some degree of arthritis so that the knee is not under as much load with each step. And then there are other options for the patellofemoral arthritis as well as for the rest of the knee, as well as for knee arthritis in general, such as injections. And injections can be cortisone, which is a very potent anti-inflammatory for somebody who has an acute flare or swelling in their knee, or we're using a lot more what we call viscosupplementation injections, which are lubricating injections. They are hyaluronic acid, which is the fluid that your knee normally produces. It's just more of it, and we can give those as well, which have become very useful in the management of mild to moderate arthritis.